Hello everyone, my name is Divyanshu Seth, and if I'll talk about my professional career, I'm having 5.5 years of experience in securities. I have worked on multiple vendors such as Cisco Palo Alto, Juniper, Checkpoint, as well as F5 load balancers. I have core experience in Cisco as well as in Palo Alto technology. I am CCNA certified and I did PCNSC also. So let's just quickly go through about the training, the topic which we are going to cover today, that is regarding the Palo Alto Firewall training. So before going to the Palo Alto Firewall training, let's just deal with the basics of security. So our first topic for discussion is, what is firewall? When I'm saying a firewall, it can be a software, a hardware, or a combination of both, which basically helps in protecting our environment, our infrastructure from unauthorized access from the external resources. So when we are saying firewall, what is the role of a firewall? Why we use only firewall? What kind of device it is? So firewall is basically a network security device, which helps in monitoring the incoming as well as outgoing traffic based on the rules, the access list, how we are configuring the access. Are we allowing the access or blocking the particular access for an internal as well as the external resources, so that we can protect our environment from the attacker, the hackers, which are trying to gaining the access of our infrastructure. We basically deployed the firewalls in our LAN as well as on WAN segments. When we are talking about firewall, we need to discuss regarding the generations of firewall first. We have packet filtering firewall, we have proxy firewalls, we have stateful inspection firewalls, as well as we have the application next generation firewall. When I'm talking about the packet filtering firewalls, it basically deals when a traffic is entering or leaving to the network, and based on the predefined rules, it allow and denies a particular traffic. When I'm talking about the proxy firewall is basically works on the real mass network addresses and intercept the every message basis on it is entering or leaving to the network. When I'm talking about the stateful inspection firewall, it has the capabilities of packet filtering firewall, as well as it maintains a connection table, which includes all the session details. It should have the source IP, destination IP, the port which we are requesting, the type of protocol which we are using, and it maintains that particular connection table. When I'm talking about the application next generation firewall, it has the capabilities of layer 3, layer 4, as well as the layer 7 features, which examines the content, the application which the user is demanding or trying to access, whether it can be internal user or an external user. And based on that, it examines the packet, how we need to deal with it. So why are we using the next generation firewall? So next generation firewall is basically the latest generation of firewall technologies, which has a combination of traditional firewall features and has inbuilt capabilities of add-on layer 7 features, just like deep packet level inspection, the IPS features, intrusion prevention system, the IDS features. It basically examines the TLS SSL encrypted traffic also, and it works on multiple bandwidth management, antivirus inspection, and it deals with many identity management tools also, just like LDAP, RADIUS, Active Directory. That's all. So when we are discussing about the Palo Alto, we first need to know what is Palo Alto. So here we are going to discuss about the introduction of Palo Alto. Next generation firewall includes the enterprise firewall capabilities. When we are saying enterprise firewall capabilities, it deals with the infrastructure of our environment, the organization level. It has the inbuilt capabilities of IPS as well as application control features. And Palo Alto delivers all these features into a next generation firewall. It basically uses the SP3 architecture, which we are going to discuss later on in this slide only, which includes the single platform parallel processing and single management system. When we are talking about Palo Alto, we can consider the multiple management systems which it has. It includes, just like the next generation firewall features, which includes the application ID, content ID, user ID, antivirus, anti-spyware, wildfire. These are the features of Palo Alto, which it provides. So Here we need to discuss about the single pass parallel processing architecture. When I am saying single pass, it examines the packet once per packet. It examines the packet once per packet and perform all the operations in it, just like networking operations, policy lookup, app identification, and decoding the signature, matching signatures. That's all. So when I'm talking about the parallel processing, what does parallel processing means? So Palo Alto designed in such a manner so that it can separate the data plane traffic and the control plane traffic to provide the parallel processing. There are several critical functions which it uses while dividing the packet. So it includes the network routing, flow lookup, data counting, NAT, similar functions. Okay. It includes the features such as app ID, content ID, user ID, etc. So in this training, we are going to learn multiple things about Palo Alto. We will go through the entire training of Palo Alto. We will cover all those modules which we have mentioned here, just like covering the SP3 architectures, the platform architectures, the firewall platform, module of initial configuration, how to configure the firewall, how to initialize the firewall, how to do the upgrades of firewall software upgrades. Later on, we are going to cover the interface configuration, what are the types of interfaces which we have, and how to configure those, where we need to use those. We are going to cover about the security and NAT policies. When I'm security policies, it deals with the access list. It's not more than an access list only. So it has security as well as NAT policies. We're going to cover those things also. We're going to cover the app ID feature, how to use app ID. We are going to cover content ID, URL filtering, decryption, as well as WildFire. Later on this course, we are going to cover the user identification, how to use that, what are the configuration we need to do for the user ID, as well as what is the best practice for this one. Later on, we are going to cover the Global Protect, which is basically the VPN of Palo Alto, and the site-to-site VPN. Later on in this case, we will cover monitoring and reporting, high availability, and at the end of this module, we are going to cover the security best practices, which will be a bonus part of it, in which we will explain you the routing concepts, just like the dynamic routing, static routing, RIP, OSPF, BGP, and we will tell you why we are not using EIGRP here, some Panorama basics, how to put the packet capture, what is captive portal, and there are some basic comments which we are going to tell you regarding the CLI part also, so that you will be able to understand how to troubleshoot through CLI also, because majorly Palo Alto will get used in GUI, but for doing the troubleshooting, we can use the CLI also, and it will be very much helpful if we need to do a deep level of troubleshooting. That's all from my end. Thank you so much.